All praise the studio. How why you? How was shot? How about Shemaine was shot? Double honors to our elders, a great millstone, and blessings to all the brothers all around the earth. This one I got right here is on the tribe of Reuben, which their contemporary derogatory name, I like to say, is known as Seminole Indian. The word Seminole, when you look it up, means rebellious. Out of Gad and Reuben, Reuben was the only one that didn't sign peace treaties. All right, Gad signed peace treaties. I'm not trying to down Gad. Please don't think that I am. They signed peace treaties, but every one of them was reneged. Esau reneged on. But I'm gonna get into this. This is the Seminole Wars. There was three Seminole Wars. The first one was 1817 to 1818. The second one was 1835 to 1842, and 1855 to 1858. Now it says Seminoles of Florida. The first Seminole War, 1817-1818, started over attempts by U.S. authorities to recapture runaway slaves living among Seminole lands. It's like his Seminole bands, all right? So you know that was basically Judah, Benjamin, and Levi finding refuge with the tribe of Reuben, okay? It says, under General Andrew Jackson, U.S. military invaded the area, scattering villagers, burning their towns, and seizing their lands. Seizing land that was owned by the Spanish, like Pensacola and St. Marks. As a result, in 1819, Spain was induced to cede its Florida territory. That's the first Seminole War. The second Seminole War is 1835 to 1842. The second Seminole War, 1835 to 1842, followed by refusal of most Seminoles to abandon the reservation that had been made specifically for them north of Lake Okeechobee and to relocate west of the Mississippi River. I wrote it down here this way. It says, Edomites coveted this land and thought to oust the Seminoles under the Indian Removal Act. Led by Chief Escola, the Seminole warriors hid their families in the Everglades and fought hard to defend their homes using guerrilla tactics. Around 2,000 U.S. soldiers were killed, which cost U.S. government between $40 million and $60 million. After Oscola's capture, did Seminole resistance decline? Okay, now the third and final Seminole War is 1855 to 1858. The third Seminole War came from renewed efforts. Now see that, this devil is the fucking devil. Said the third Seminole War came from renewed efforts to track down the Seminole remnant remaining in Florida. Can you believe that shit? And then you got idiots out there that tell you the white man's your friend, right? It says it caused more bloodshed and ended with the U.S. paying most resistant band of refugees to go west. So they paid them off to go west. Places like Arizona, the Dakotas, South and North Dakota, which is considered parts of the Midwest.